Welcome to Snake Island. In the last episode, the extremely hot weather and sun exposure quickly dehydrated my body, and my assumed water source of coconuts turned up dry. In desperation, I ate lots of cactus, but I didn't know how much longer I could continue like this. This episode begins with a warm, sunny morning on the Northwest Point and no rain in sight.
Good morning! This is such a beautiful location. And that piece of plastic, I don't know what this is for exactly, but this was actually a decent place to sleep. But I'm not gonna lie to you, I'm not doing too good. I'm quite miserable in fact. But the first night that I was spent on that other beach where I made that makeshift shelter, well, that beach was inundated with no-see-um bugs, biting midges, mimes, chaquistes, whatever you know them as. Let me just tell you, they were unbelievably prevalent. It was fine when I got there because there was a steady breeze and the wind keeps them away. But unfortunately, later in the night, the wind died down and they came out and they had a feast with me. I estimate at least 500 bites. And the funny thing about the no-see-um bugs is the bite doesn't take effect. The itching doesn't take effect for about 24 hours. So yesterday, I felt fine. They weren't bothering me at all. But today, as soon as the sun started coming up, I had to take off my clothes and I felt like a madman for a moment, just wanting to scratch and itch and was going insane. Afterwards, the burn was continuing and I rubbed some of the cactus pulp on it. I don't know, that might help it. It seems okay right now after I scratch and then I add the cactus pulp. So I'm hoping I'm not gonna suffer too much today with that. In my experience, when I start sweating, when it gets really hot, it really gets really unbearable. But I'm gonna try to do some swimming and hopefully the salt water will help dry it out or cure it, whatever. The other thing, I haven't had water for about 14 hours. My water ran out at 14 hours ago. Since then, all I've been eating is the cactus. That's not good. Without water, you just can't eat. So I'm gonna eat more cactus, but I gotta get back and get a source of water. I was hoping for rain, but as you can see, the weather has been unbelievably great for the beach, great for the tourists, but this has now turned into a real life survival situation because if I'm gonna stay out here very much longer, I need water. And my intention wasn't to make this a survival test. I wanted to explore. Over the 2 weeks that I'm planning to be here, I want to explore just survival techniques. But in a survival situation, I wouldn't be doing this. I wouldn't be recording. I wouldn't be carrying all this camera gear. That's just nonsense. I would be getting to the next coconut palms where I know I can get some good water. We're going to make the most of today. If I get a little cranky, please forgive me.
Dehydration is really uncomfortable. Imagine your mouth and throat being completely dry. It even becomes difficult to speak.
I get lucky. I can hardly talk, my mouth's so dry. I found some cactus right here. This is on top of the hill. I thought I'd look up here and see if there's anything. There's plenty of cactus up here. All right, so I'm gonna climb down this hill, eat this up, and they'll replenish me for a little while. But I don't have much time. I gotta get out of here. I gotta get water. It's gonna be a hot day. There's lots of sunshine. This is for real. My mouth is really, really dry. So I'm gonna eat the core, which is much, it's very similar to a cucumber. It's got lots of water.
At first, I was a little apprehensive about taking the board out there alone, but then again, that's what adventure is all about.
Yeah, I'd like to have some cool drinks, some hot food, a ribeye steak with a salad. You think you're so great being on that ship while I'm all alone out here getting bitten by no-see-um bugs, dehydrated, hungry. But you know what? I bet you guys don't even get to swim in the water. You don't even get to touch the sea. I swam to that island over there. I swam over there. I looked under the water. I felt the water just surround me and refresh my body. And you'll get none of that. Yeah, just ignore me. Keep going. Ah, the great outdoors.
No matter how much we may despise people at times, being alone for an extended period of time definitely intensifies the desire for human interaction.
Oh, this color looks fantastic on you. There we go. Sally, you're looking great. Oh my God! I can't believe it! It's raining! Yes! Woo! Yeah! The water's falling! It's coming from heaven! Yeah! Thank you, God! Looks like it's stopping. Oh, look how much I got. That's gonna help a lot. I'm so desperate, I don't wanna waste any of it. There's little drops on here. Look at it. Oh, that's a lot of water. Let's get up as much of it as I can. All this little, look at that. See, I can get a little bit in there. And that can do a lot to quench, a whole lot to quench my thirst. Oh, it tastes so great. That's one of the great benefits to carrying plastic bags with you on these trips. The sun is back out now, but it left me a drinkable amount of water. That's at least That's probably about 8 ounces. It's not a lot. I could get some more drops to go down. I might be able to get 9 or 10 ounces out of this. Sally's pleased. I'm pleased. This is a lifesaver. I brought this with me on my trip. This will be very practical for getting that water from there to inside here. Here we go. But what I want to do is I want to shake these droplets that are collected here. I won't be able to get them all. They won't all shake loose. But you can see, more water is dripping down to the reservoir. And what I'll do is pull this inward like this.
You done that?
That was about 8 ounces of water. That's the first water I've had in about 18 hours, something like that. It just tasted magnificent, so good. I feel so much better, but it's not gonna last long. I know that in an hour I'm gonna be all dried out again. Well, I did try do one more thing. I used the evapo-perspiration method to try to collect some water. I had set this up this morning. So I'm gonna see how much water I got. I know it's not much because it's only been a few hours. Like you see, yeah, that's some water on the outside from the rain. We got, this one didn't produce, it's kind of open. It's gotta be tightly closed. It's the only way it'll work. I think it's got a tiny bit. And this is a bigger bag. It's got a little bit more. It's not much. It's only going to give me a little sip. But it's something. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to save this. I'm going to stash it away up here. I might come back. Okay. Boogie board, I just stashed away up there. High above the surf line. If a hurricane comes, I don't know, it's gonna probably fly away. But if we don't have a hurricane, that might be there for years to come. So keep it a secret, don't tell anyone. If you come and use the boogie board to swim to that island over there, go for it. I'm willing to share it. But just bring it back, stow it away up there. And you know what, let me know if you actually used it. I'd like to know about that. All right, it's time to continue on. I've got to go probably 3-4 miles, I'm not sure, but I have to do it. I'm already feeling like I haven't had water. I'm thirsty, but I know I at least got 8 ounces in me, it's gonna help, and I gotta go straight for a water source. It'll probably be the town, and I'll just stock up on, fill up all my containers, plus an extra couple bottles, because you really use a lot of water out here.
I was able to collect about 8 ounces of water to drink. And even that small amount felt so relieving. But soon after, I felt totally dehydrated again. Fortunately, I found a surprisingly unique way to help alleviate the effects of dehydration. Swimming.
That's a bunker. More cactus. I really gotta have some more. My throat's so dry again. I'm so thankful for this cactus. Even though I have no desire to eat it, I know that if it weren't for this cactus, I wouldn't have made it this far. I would have died from food exhaustion probably this morning, yesterday, I don't know. And my throat is just so dry. I really have no desire to eat cactus anymore. I want a really tall glass of lemonade. I don't know what it is, but even though I just was feeling sort of weak, really hot, dehydration, but when I went in that water, it's almost like my body absorbs water through the sea, right through my skin or something, because I just feel totally refreshed right now. I mean, I feel thirsty, but I don't have that dryness in my throat, and I just feel better. The sea is really amazing. I could just spend all day in there.
Even though I was severely dehydrated, it amazed me how much better I felt while in the water. It was as if my body absorbed fresh water right through my skin. From that point on, I desired to be in the water as much as possible. Many stretches of the coastline are so rugged that the only way to go is through the water.
It's actually really feeling good. Oh my gosh. This water feels so amazing. Yeah, I'm gonna go for another swim. I wanna see what it looks like under there. I think it's really deep. Let's check it out. Wow, that smells so good. It's beautiful. Swimming with all my clothes on turned out to be the best way to reduce my perspiration and subsequent effects of dehydration. Wow. Well, oh yes. I actually feel quite a bit better. I still feel tired, relaxed, thirsty. Oh yes. Look at that. 3 or 4 fruits ready for me to pick. Oh, I really need this. It's not much. It's nice when you're hungry and you're thirsty and you're tired. It's very nice. Well, I'm almost at Carlos Rosario. I'm going swimming again. Come on, I need some more. I really need some water. This is Carlos Rosario Beach. I'm going to go for a swim first.
I finally made it to Carlos Rosario Beach and the first evidence of humans I had seen in 2 days.
So I'm gonna go swimming. This will be an interesting experiment to see if it actually rejuvenates me or reinvigorates me or makes me just feel better. Because right now I'm pretty low, real low. I think dangerously low. I just wanna lay down and fall asleep. So I'm gonna jump out there. And if my guess is correct, I'll instantly feel a lot better. Okay, well, test results. That actually made me feel better. I feel better, except there's one problem. The dehydration has caused a serious muscle cramp in my trapezius. I can't even lift this arm up. It's so intensely painful. That's not good. Oh my Lord. Well, I'm gonna go to Playa Tamarindo and see if there's anyone there that has a bottle of water that I could buy from them. This is the pathway to Playa Carlos Rosario that I just went to. Some people here too. There's the pathway to Flamenco. Those two guys were very nice and informative. Turns out this is the trail. I take this and it goes to a little road that will take me right to Flamenco. Yes, I see coconut palms. I made it. Paradise found. Gotta wait. Feels like an eternity for this. It's gonna take time to rehydrate. This looks amazing. 32 ounce lemonade with real lemons, $5. It's got a lot of sugar, but it's cold. It's gonna be so refreshing. Whoa. Look, I'm just like you. I don't like eating cactus. It doesn't taste near as good as this. It doesn't taste near as good as a lot of things. I'm really, really exhausted. My shoulder, I got that cramp in that muscle. That's really weird. I've never had that happen before. I'm sure it's due to dehydration. I got some good news. My bites aren't itching anymore. I scratched them and then I applied the cactus to them and then I went swimming and it's gone. There's like a slight burning sensation just because I scratched the skin, I damaged the skin a little bit. But that is far better than that burning sensation, that burning itch sensation that the noceum bugs cause after 24 hours of them biting you. So that's good news. So if I do get bitten by them again, I'll try not to panic. Of course, I won't be able to sleep at all if that's the case. I don't know, maybe I'll just go spend the night in the water. Oh Lord, that water feels good.
This was an easy harvest. Found it on the ground.
The lemonade I drank at Flamenco Beach was truly amazing. Altogether, I drank close to 3 liters of water, then I rinsed off in the outdoor showers and headed back on the path to Tamarindo Grande Beach to look for a place to camp.
It's beautiful. The sound of the birds in the late afternoon and evening. Okay, I'm walking back to the beach that's over by Carlos Rosario, and I'm gonna go and spend the night somewhere around there. I have 3 liters of water, 3 liters of fresh water to drink, which will get me through tomorrow. Tomorrow I don't have a very long distance that I'm gonna cover. I'm gonna make it an easy day. I need to recover from the dehydration and just energy expense. I haven't been eating, so I'm finally gonna start eating now. There's a plane. So, my energy levels should rise tomorrow as I'm introducing food into my body starting tonight. Can't believe all I ate all day was cactus. Insane.
I thought about putting my hammock right here, but after carefully considering, that would be a really bad idea.
This tree is called manchineal. In Spanish, it's called Manzanilla de la Muerte, and that translates to little tree of death. It's called that because it's one of the most poisonous. It's the most poisonous tree in the world. And I know how to identify it because I've actually eaten the fruit by accident, just a tiny bit. Got a little sick, a friend of mine got much sicker. But at this time of year, it doesn't appear to have fruit. We found fruit in January, but the leaves, this is how the leaves look. This is the trunk, and it's said that the sap is the most poisonous. If you burn the wood and the smoke gets in your eyes, they say it will cause blindness. Carib Indians, who used to inhabit these islands a long, long time ago before the Spanish conquest, they were known to tie their victims up to the trunk of one of these trees and just wait for the rains to come, because when the rains would fall, it would carry the poisonous toxic material from the leaves and the branches, and it'd be like acid, and would literally just burn the skin on their captives, and they would die a very slow, painful death. So that's a manchineal tree, and that's the reason you don't want to camp under it, because if it were to rain, I could get some serious trouble. Generally, they say anyone who has contact with the manchineal tree ends up in ER. This tree is a very common one here. It gets these big heart-shaped leaves, and I've camped underneath them many, many times before. My only concern about this area is that it's very dark. Looks like mosquitoes would love it. But I do have a antidote for the mosquitoes. I just cover myself with plastic trash bags. They don't like that. Hopefully there aren't any of those biting midges, better known as no-see-um bugs. So I'll set up my camp. The view is spectacular. This is a beautiful location, but I took a few photos and video, but oh my God, there's no seeing bugs. They're starting to feast on me, so I gotta take down my hammock and I gotta get out of here. I just gotta go somewhere where they are not at. The problem with this location is that there's absolutely no wind, zero wind. When you're camping outside in the Caribbean, wind is your friend. Wind keeps the mosquitoes away, and wind keeps the no-see-em bugs away. Without wind, they can just fly easily wherever they want. They will find you. They're like little tiny terminators, and they absolutely will not stop until they've eaten you alive. I'm sure I'd be much better off if I just made a camp up here. There isn't really any place to hang a hammock though. There's trees, but it's all dense vegetation all around them. You can't have that. But no seeing bugs, I doubt they'd be up here. They like to be close to water.
It quickly became dark and I couldn't shoot anymore. I ended up walking back to Flamenco Beach, then taking the road through the town of Culebra, and then up to the top of a hill overlooking Linda Bay. There I slept as best I could under my plastic tarp while a light rain fell. On the next Snake Island survival adventure, I find a quiet little beach to spend a relaxing day, and then I'm blessed by a major rainfall followed by a visit from a green dinosaur.